Hey, you too. Flatwoods Bushcraft here. Somebody just got pulled over. Glad it's not me. Anyway, just enjoying another day off. Enjoying a cigar. One that I got from GhostlySmoker, my Yabo. So Mareva is the only thing he had wrote on there. So I did a little research, and apparently Mareva just refers to the size. I believe it's a petite Corona, if I'm not mistaken. I believe that's right. Not sure what the brand is, because there wasn't no ring on it. But, I don't know. So far, so good. Have limited experience with cigars, so if I completely screwed that up, forgive me. But anyway, just enjoying the nice beautiful day we're having here in Kentucky. Got the day off from work, did a little running around, went to a couple tobacco shops here in town. Hoping to buy a humidor and maybe get a couple more cigars and start getting into cigars a little bit. But as with anything I want to buy, this town just doesn't have it. I mean, it doesn't matter what I want. It just, I can't find it. I mean, even the simplest things, like, you know, I wanted a Leatherman Squirt PS4. When I went to buy my Squirt, it should be a common thing. Like, Walmart should have it. Like, everybody should have one of those. It's like, it seems to me like it should be, you know, in every sporting goods store. Couldn't find it anywhere. I had to order it off of Amazon. So, went to the place where I had found the pipe tobacco last time, the McBurton blends and the Dunhill. Went there because I remember they had a humidor with a couple cigars, which, yeah, is more than most places around here. Most places just have Swisher Sweets and, you know, Backwoods hand-rolled cigars, and, you know, maybe Garcia Vega or whatever they're called, you know, the cheap crappy cigars. So I went there and was like, hey, you guys have any humidors? He's like, yeah, we got one right there with all the any for sale. Oh, no. I'm like, okay, well, how many humipacks? Do you have any humipacks? Because I was figuring, well, maybe I could at least sustain what I have a little bit longer and not feel rushed to smoke them, and, you know, maybe pick up a few more cigars and, you know, put them in a Tupperware with some humipacks. Should be a little better than being in Ziploc bags with humipacks. But he didn't even know what I was talking about. So I went to another store, Ashland Beverage Company. There, it's like it's a liquor store, package store, but they have a bigger selection of cigars, and I heard this was the place to go in town for cigars. So I went there. They had some better cigars, but nobody knew what I was talking about. No humidors for sale, obviously. I wasn't really expecting them to have humidors, but I figured, you know, maybe they would know what a humipack is, and maybe have gotten some cigars with humipacks in them, and might be willing to part with them. And that the guy there, as I explained what the Hemopack is and what they're for and what they do and what they look like, and he was like, well, it sounds like what cricket breeders use to keep moisture levels, you know, regulated in, you know, batches of crickets when they send them, you know, from bait shop to keep them alive and all. So I was like, well, I guess I'm screwed on the humidor or Humapacks today. You guys that live in a place that has a good tobacco store, you just don't realize how good you have it. I mean, pretty much, I'm 3 days away from anything. If I want something, I've got to order it, pay shipping, and wait 3 days for it. And I'm just not that type of person. I like instant gratification. I like to be able to go and buy something and enjoy it. Like, today's my day off. I wanted to go get a humidor, you know, start the seasoning process, and then, you know, by the weekend have cigars put in it and go buy some cigars and put in there. Not gonna happen. The flavor profile just got a little sweeter on this. As it burns a little bit, it started out kind of harsh, like real cigar tobacco leaf, that, you know, that taste you get in the back of your throat that's kind of harsh. I don't know if I'm describing it properly, but, you know, that's the way, when I think of a cheap cigar, I think of, you know, that real harsh, you know, dry tobacco wrapper taste, I guess. And that's kind of the way this started, but as I'm going along, it's getting sweeter and getting more mellow, so, I can see myself liking it. It's not something I want to smoke every day, though. So anyway, if any of you have suggestions on where Humapacks might be located locally, like, is this something that you might find, you know, do they use them for other purposes? Is it only for tobacco products? Do they use them, you know, could you possibly find them in a Walmart or a grocery store, you know? Do they have, you know, I don't know. I've never really had to deal with them. So, you know, are they used for other things? Can you find them somewhere else? Do I have to order them online and pay $3 shipping for, you know, $2 worth of Humapacks? You know, let me know. Like I said, I'm new to the cigars, and of course, pipe tobacco needs to be at a much lower humidity level. This one, I think, I don't have a hemostat or a hydrometer, or however you pronounce it. I don't know, it feels real tight in the wrapper, like kind of like it's too moist and the tobacco's swelling. You know, it's kind of a tight draw, so I'm thinking maybe that Humapack that this was in with was keeping it at a too high of a humidity level, I think. I don't know. I may be wrong, but that's just my initial opinion or thought. But anyway, while I was there, at the Ashland Beverage Company, I picked up a couple of cigars. I couldn't really get any suggestions on what to buy, so I just went with names I've heard of before. And I may have, like, got the exact wrong cigar, but I don't know. I got a Romeo y Julieta 1875 Reserva, or whatever it said. I don't know, I'm not good with Spanish names or South American or whatever language they have those in. And I'm not going to try to throw some Americanized accent when I pronounce it. Romeo y Juliet. I don't know. But the guy said it was a mellow cigar. It didn't say Robusto, so I figured, who knows. The other one I got was a Punch. And I can't remember what kind of Punch. It was similar in size, just a little bit smaller than the Romeo y Julieta. It was kind of a lighter brown wrapper. But I don't know. We'll give it a shot. I hope they're good, because it was like $10 worth of cigars, two cigars. I don't know if I can afford to smoke cigars very often, because seems like a very expensive hobby. And I don't make a whole lot of money. But, you know, to celebrate special occasions and occasional, you know, treat yourself to something good, I can see that. But an everyday cigar smoker, I can never afford it. But picked up a tin of, restocked my stock of McBaron plum cake and the Scottish mixture. I was completely out of the Scottish mixture. I love that stuff. That's one of my go-to smokes. I like it. I like plum cake a lot too. I probably had like maybe an ounce and a half, 2 ounces of plum cake left. But I figured while I was there, I might as well get it before it was gone. He only had one tin left. And their prices on the McBaron stuff is pretty comparable to what PopsandCigars.com had. So I figured I'd save the shipping and the weight and get some. I'm probably just offending the hell out of you cigar smokers out there the way I'm smoking the cigar. But you know, hell, we all gotta start somewhere. It's staying pretty evenly lit. Yeah. I know there's a name for that, but it escapes me. I don't know what you guys call it from where I'm from. I better not even use that term. But anyway, I'm slobbering all over this thing. I don't know if that's proper either. Where I'm from, we call it a derogatory term, lipping. And those of you who've heard it before probably know exactly what I'm saying. But I don't want to offend anybody out there. I come from a real racist state, so you can kind of guess what that is. Anyway, I just thought I'd bring you along for the cigar. Thanks again, Ghostly Smoker, for sending me the cigar. I don't have my tripod with me, so my left arm's getting kind of tired right now, so I'm not going to bore you any longer with my terrible attempt at smoking a cigar and sit back and enjoy it. So, anyway. Hope you guys have a great day. We'll catch you on the next one.